If there would be some live sound, you would hear me curse quite a bit during the next few minutes. Join me on an awesome paragliding XC adventure through the Swiss Alps. In this flight, we'll explore one of the most beautiful areas of Switzerland, and we'll also try and race against the incoming clouds to make it as far as we can towards home. So come along and see where we end up and learn a ton about XC decision making on the go. So here we're just in front of the Bianco Grat, which has these beautiful snow deposits on top. They're kind of like snow dunes, so it's really quite unique. So in the first part of this flight, the goal was to just cruise around, enjoy the high mountain air, appreciate that we can get up here without any hefty mountaineering skills or a lot of gear, and just cruise around under our paraglider. But on the second part of the flight, I also wanted to fly towards home in order to shorten the train ride and have an easier journey. And as you can see on the left hand side, there are some high clouds moving in, which bring quite a bit of shade and eliminate all the thermals. So I do have to race quite a bit in order to avoid these clouds and make it as far as I can towards home. I'm still playing around here a bit, but I have to soon optimize all my XC parameters such as glide and climb. So I'm aiming straight for this good looking cloud in front and I start climbing. I'm really trying to maximize the altitude in this section, because soon enough there will be quite a big valley crossing. And here and in general, you always want to try to stay out of the valley wind, because once you get pinged down by the valley wind, you can get stuck for quite a while, or you may even be forced to land. So I have made base and I'm going on the transition. I could aim for the right ridge, which is a bit closer, or I could aim for the left ridge, which is a bit in the back. I do think I have enough altitude to make it towards the more direct but further ridge in the back, so I aim straight for this. I'm aiming also for this little kind of nose that sticks out as a thermal trigger. And you can see I struggle in the beginning quite a bit to hook the climb, but ultimately I do find the thermal and I climb out on this little nose. Overall, it's always a good idea to climb on a first trigger. And once you have enough altitude, move over the highest peak or the main ridge, because there the thermal is usually much stronger. So this was true here and I could climb up very quick. Now I'm cruising along just this beautiful ridge line and you can see it's well marked by good cumulus clouds. Overall, it's sweet cruising and I stay quite high, because in the back you can see there's already the next valley crossing coming up, and I want to be as high as possible in order to have all the options open to aim for a good trigger point to climb again very fast and efficiently. So I have made base again and I'm going on transition. In order to find the best point to aim at, I'm letting myself guide by the clouds. So usually the clouds that have a flat bottom and are well developed have the strongest climb underneath it. So I aim straight for this cloud and I climb up quickly. Here I'm going again on transition. You can see on the left hand side there are a lot of high clouds moving in and there is a lot of shade, so I have to hurry up. So you can see in front there are no good clouds above this ridge. This ridge is just too much in the valley wind, so the thermals get blown away. So I do decide I skip this ridge and aim for the ridge in the back, which has much better clouds above it. I do aim for the ridge, and judging by the clouds I would expect a strong thermal. But if there would be some live sound, you would hear me curse quite a bit during the next few minutes, because I cannot find a good thermal straight away. So I have to soar this ridge quite a bit. And you can see I'm flying left, I'm flying right. It's going up generally, but there is no good ripper of a climb as I expected. So I really have to tap into my patience reserves here and soar along the ridge. If you get a bit dizzy, look at the shadow. It's a bit better to avoid motion sickness. So eventually I do get up above the ridge line, but even above the ridge line I don't find a strong thermal that takes me up to base. So I still have to really tap into my patience reserves and just take my time, slowly climb up to base in order to cruise along these good looking clouds and be as efficient as I can to avoid the clouds that are quickly approaching. So I do make it up to base eventually and I can continue my journey towards home and race along underneath these clouds. So I'm again on another transition, and in this section of the Engadin there is often quite a bit of wind coming in from the north. So you do see there's a good looking cloud ahead, but it doesn't really correspond to any peak or ridge. So it's too far in the back for this ridge and too much in the front for the peak that is in the shadow in the back. So I decide to skip this area altogether because I cannot find a good climb and aim straight for the next ridge, which is still in the sun and has some good looking clouds above it. And I do arrive quite high on this ridge, and as you would expect there is a good climb when I arrive, so I make it over the ridge, there is absolutely no problem, and I straight hook this good climb. As you can see to the left there is quite a bit of shade, so this is actually the last ridge that is still in the sun. So I do need to hurry up and make it to base as fast as I can in order not to get eaten by the clouds. But fortunately the thermals are quite good and the climbs underneath these clouds are also quite strong. So in order to not get sucked in by the clouds but still maximize my altitude, I do aim a little bit for the edge of the cloud here. This is generally quite a good tactic, so you can surf along the edge of the cloud but you still don't risk of getting sucked into the cloud. I'm preparing for the next transition, so I will move over one of the main ridges here into another area called the Prätigau. So I have made base and I'm cruising over this pass in order to get into another valley. As you can see now, the shade has caught up with me, so ahead there are only clouds and there is no more sun. But you can see also above the ridge line there are still some good looking clouds which appear to be still alive. So I still do aim for the ridge and I hope to grab one last climb in this flying day. So often there are still some good climbs to be had, even maybe an hour after all the sun has gone, because the rocks are still hot and give off this heat later in the day. As you can see, I can find a climb and it's not super strong, but it still brings me back up to base. And here I make sure that I really milk it to the max because I know there is no better climb around. Everything else is in the shade. So I really want to make a maximum out of the few thermals that are left. So you can see there's still some development here and there. Some clouds come up. Also notice how much lower the cloud base is. Often when there is some shade moving in, the temperature drops a bit. Maybe there's also more moist air coming in. So this all leads towards a lower cloud base. So ahead you can see there are no more good clouds. There are actually no more cumulus clouds in front. There is just this high cirrus which shades in all of the terrain. So I don't expect a good thermal anymore. So I'm just cruising along the ridge and I'm trying to maximize my glide here in order to still make it a few kilometers more towards home in order to not to spend so much time in the train. So when you're just trying to maximize the glide, it's often a good idea to follow the terrain as closely as you can or feel comfortable, because often there is a good flow up the terrain. So this is also the case here. You can see I'm maintaining quite well following this ridge line, And even though there's no more climb, I have a very buoyant and good glide. But I also sometimes, of course, have to aim a bit outside in order to avoid the flat parts of the terrain. So in moments like this, it's basically game over, but it's also time to maybe kick back, enjoy what a beautiful sport paragliding is, enjoy the privilege that we have to see the world from above, to take this time out of the busy daily life, and enjoy just what's around us, see what's going on underneath. So I have not made it home, I still need to take a train to arrive all the way back. But that's no big deal, because I had a beautiful flight. I enjoyed some of the most beautiful areas of Switzerland. I could cruise above the Bianco Grat, which is quite unique. And I really had a blast. So I hope you had a good time too watching this video. And I hope you learned something to improve your XC game and have more fun in the air.